wake me up, please let me be. I wanna stay away. This is how I want it to be. This is the way, so I wanna stay. Do not disturb me, don't try to break into my house of cards. This is how I want it to be. This is the way, so I wanna stay. It won't last forever, though I wish it would, and I guess it could. You never should say never, but one thing I know, I'd hate to go.
To Britt Arnell on YouTube on this 12th episode of 2020. I made the Norwegian episode yesterday, Friday. Today it's Saturday, and I'm here to do the English one. And I feel the more English episodes I do, the more I struggle. The Norwegian ones are quite easy because I know the theme I want to talk about. And I kind of just start talking and it unfolds almost by itself. Well, not just as easy, but still. It's so much easier to find the words and to explain the meaning I want to share with you in the Norwegian episode. And this episode is supposed to be about time. And in Norway, we have a saying which we say good time. You have good time, then you have enough time. Or you have bad time, which means you are in a hurry. Good time, god tid. Bad time, bad times, dårlig tid. And in the Norwegian episode, I'm talking about this because good time, why does it have to mean that you are not in a hurry? Or that you don't have much to do. What actually does good time mean? Maybe it means that what you are doing feels good for you. You are in a good mood, you can be busy, but still you can have a good time because you are doing what you like, what you are supposed to do, what makes you happy, or what is the purpose of your life. I can hear now when I tried to discuss this in English, I struggled to find the right words. But I talk a lot about that in the Norwegian episode. And the reason why I talk about time is that I have had my first week as a retired now. I had my last day of work before Easter. Then we had Easter break. And now when other people are back to work, I am retired. I go to bed every night with a smile on my face, looking forward to the next day. I wake up the next day, still with a smile on my face. Yes, a new day. What can I use the new day? How can I use the new day? So far, I love this these days of retirement. But also, I can feel that they kind of they make me a little stressful because there are so many things I want to do. So I can start in the morning and I have to do this and this and this and this and this and hardly find time for a break and then continue. And I have decided I don't want my life to be like that. I want to live the slow life. So I have to tell myself that You can't read all the books you want. You can't knit all the knitting you want to do. You can't bake all the things you want to do. You can't continue to do all the things you have planned you wanted to do. Because I want to live the slow life. But still, I do a lot. But I do it in a slow pace. And I try to have good days. Of course, I still have worries, I have struggles, I can be angry, I can be sad, I can cry, all this. But I try to reflect on how I can live my days in a good way. What I'm saying in English is, well, said in a very different way from the Norwegian way, but that's fine. The first video you saw was from a walk I did a few days ago. I think it was Thursday, 2 days ago, up in the hills. I had to drive there, but still it's not very far from us. I walked around a small lake, Teisendammen, and I loved it there. You can see signs of the beavers. You can see some birds, still some snow, but with the amazing anticipation of spring in the air. I hope you liked it. And the music was, as always, with my sister-in-law from Iceland. I will put a link down under here to where you can find more of her lovely music. I have some knitting to show you, but not very much actually. In my last episode a week ago, which was on my birthday, and which was in Norwegian only, I talked about this yarn, Trinidad Superwash, which is in different colors, beautiful rainbow yarn. And I said that I wanted to make a pair of half mittens with it, which I have done. I will put them on. They are long, they are soft, and I love them. I plan to have them out in my greenhouse when it's a little cold there and I work out there. They can be my warming half mittens. I had a funny experience when I was knitting on these mittens, because coming maybe halfway up the first one, I said to myself, I think I have done this before. This feels so familiar. And then I realized that I have already knitted a pair of wrist warmers in the almost the same yarn. So I went over to the shelf, the drawer where I have all my wrist warmers, and look here. They are not exactly the same, because this doesn't have the thumb, and they don't have the rib down here and up here. So they are kind of rolling up, which I love. I have had them for many years and I have used them a lot. But when I started this new half mittens, seriously, I couldn't remember. So now I have two pairs of rainbow wrist warmers, the wrist warmers and the half mittens, and I love them both and will keep both of them. That's about almost the only thing I have been working on the past week. Being retired means there isn't much time for anything, for everything. It's not quite true, of course. I have been working on my cardigan, The Sun in Stockholm, and I'm up to under the sleeves now, and I have knitted one sleeve and halfway on the second, and I have kind of come to not a dead end, but a kind of end, because I need to figure out, I don't have a pattern, I'm making it up while I work, while I knit, so I have to figure out where to put in the sleeves. I will do a raglan. So there will be some counting, you see, Yes, here is where I will cut for the jacket to open it for the opening, and the beautiful leaves I have knitted. So I am working on my jacket and will continue to work on it. And I have been since the last English episode, because I didn't have one in English last week. I have been working on a shawl, but as it is on the needles for the moment, it's not easy to see. I will show it to you when it's finished. I do have the pattern though, with a beautiful picture here. It's a forest path hat. You find it on the Ravelry, and it's designed by a friend of mine, Patricia, who lives not far away. Patricia is originally from America, the United States, but she lives in Norway now. And she has a YouTube channel, Knitography. And in her most previous episode, she talks about how she designed this beautiful hat, a big shawl. She has a farm and she has a flock of sheep, and she's out often, every day she's out in the forest with her sheep. And it was during these days out in the forest that she has designed this beautiful hat. I will put a link to her episode, or to her podcast YouTube channel. And please go to the episode where she talks about this hat, because it's so beautiful to hear the whole designing creative process. The forest path hat. I have done something wrong, so I am knitting backwards right now. It's I have not been clear enough doing this. Oh, I can't find it. This middle stitches. So I have to knit backwards a few centimeters to make it correct, but that's okay. I'm knitting it in the Norwegian wool Finull from Rauma in a beautiful forest color. It's the original color which Patricia uses in her shawl also. So that's the knitting since the last episode. And I'm wearing a shawl. I wanted to put some knitting on, but it falls off all the time. I just think I'll leave it. I have been reading a lot. I love reading. A couple of weeks ago, my husband and I saw a film on our television about the French writer Colette. I don't know if you are familiar with her. I have her biography, but not here. I do have, I have many of her books. She wrote around 1920, 1930, I think. And I have one of the books by her, which I have, is in Norwegian. And it's a beautiful hard-covered book. Can you see this beautiful pattern? It's called Chérie, which is probably the name in English also. It's also in the Norwegian translation. And look inside the book. It's so beautiful. I know that when I have now finished reading this book, and it's not a keeper. I mean, there is no reason to keep it, to read it again. But it is a reason to keep it because it's so beautiful. But I said to myself, well, I have thousands of books in my shelves. I can't keep them all. But there is something else I can do with them. Some years ago, I used to do a lot of scrapbooking. I have many books. One of them is this one. I think I worked on it back in 2005, doing one page, one or two pages every week. Through the year, when I came to April or something, I didn't finish the whole year. But I did a lot of these kind of creative, funny scrapbook pages. Bøker means books. the books I read that week. And so it continues through several months. February came with a lot of snow and skiing and so on and so on. I have many of these books. For several years, I loved to do scrapbooking. 12 years ago was the year I turned 50, and I had a plan then to make a scrapbook from my life. I managed 2 pages. I found a book I had in my shelves, a poetry book, and I also knew that this was not a book I wanted to keep. So I started to do a scrapbook. Me as a baby, with a beautiful painting, the primavera on the background. And here again, me as a baby, the first of my 2 names, Britt. I use both, Britt Arnil. And a music sheet background. One day I should finish this. The rest of the pages are just the old ones as they were. But then I decided this one can be my retirement journal, scrapbook journal. I can keep these beautiful pages. And on the written pages, I can do scrapbooking. 1 or maybe 2 pages every week or from time to time, every month. Probably sometimes every day. I don't know. I haven't started yet, but that's a plan I have. Because this book is too beautiful not to keep. The end of this episode, I will take you to my greenhouse. And I'm talking in Norwegian. And I'm not going to change that. So you have to listen to my Norwegian speaking. First, I show you around in the greenhouse as it is just now. We still have snow out in the garden, but spring in the greenhouse. And then I do some sowing with weighed seeds, weighed in Norwegian. I think it's weighed in English. Plants which will give you, they have yellow flowers. But when you use it in dyeing, they give you beautiful blue color. And I got some seeds from people who watch my YouTube channel. So you can stop if you don't want to stop it here, if you don't want to listen to my Norwegian, or no, not stop it just yet, because I have something I want to read for you. Talking about time. In the Norwegian episode, I decided to read a small chapter from the book The Little Prince. I thought I had it in Norwegian in my shelves. In English, I mean, sorry. But I realized I have 2 of them in Norwegian. The Little Prince is a lifetime favorite of mine, together with a lot of other books. And when I wrote many years ago my book about Lent and lentil traditions, I included a small passage from The Little Prince. Today I found this as a text on the internet. So I'm stealing it to reading it to you. It's to read it to you. It's chapter 23 in Antoine de Saint-Exupéry's book, The Little Prince. And I have a problem because there is a merchant or a merchant here, a man selling things. Actually, I don't know how to pronounce it in English, so I'm going to say merchant. It might be merchant. Please correct me in a comment so I can learn it correctly. Good morning, said the little prince. Good morning, said the merchant. This was a merchant who sold pills that had been invented to quench thirst. You need only swallow 1 pill a week, and you would feel no need of anything to drink. Why are you selling those? Asked the little prince. Because they save a tremendous amount of time, said the merchant. Computations have been made by experts. With these pills, you save 53 minutes in every week. And what do I do with those 53 minutes? Anything you like. As for me, the little prince said to himself, if I had 53 minutes to spend as I liked, I should walk at my leisure toward a spring of fresh water. I should walk at my leisure toward a spring of fresh water. Let's do that today. Walk at our leisure toward a spring with fresh water. Goodbye! Hei, og velkommen inn i drivhuset mitt. Jeg gleder meg jo veldig til å ha dere med i hagen. Men fortsatt så er det bare vinter, og det snør, og det snør, og det snør. Nå tror vi at det skal bli forandring til helga. Det er torsdag nå når jeg filmer det her. Og det har vært litt sol i dag. I går så var det regn og snø hele dagen. Men det at det har vært litt sol, det gjør at det blir litt varmere inn her. Så akkurat nå, selv om det ikke står på noe varme, så er det 20 grader, fordi sola har stått på litt. Vi har på varme om natta da, men temperaturen, eller ovnen er satt sånn at den slår seg av når det blir mer enn 12 grader inn her. Vi kan jo ta en liten titt på det som er her, så bare snu kameraet. Her er jo kosekroken min da, som dere har sett før. Hvor jeg gjerne sitter både å strikke og lese. Sitter og skriver ganske mye. Så er det planter som er kjøpt inn i år. Påskelilja. Stemor. Men denne oksalisen, den er sånn som overlever i kjelleren. Den har knolla, så den har jeg hatt i mange år. Og likadan denne afrikalilja, som ikke er planta av den, jeg har bare tatt den opp fra kjelleren. Og satt den oppe i den krukka der den skal stå. Så har vi vinrankene våre som ikke har begynt å vokse enda. Det er litt for tidlig. Vi klipper dem ned etter at de har begynt å vokse, sånn at vi ser hva som er dødt. Hva vi tar vekk. Vi har funnet at det er den greieste måten å gjøre det på. Så det betyr at det er ganske mye tørre vinranker inn her akkurat nå, men det skal bli bedre. Så har vi en del jordbær som overvintrer i drivhuset. Jordbær i krukka. Det er jo Leander sine, og nå blir det jo Emilian sine da. Ikke begynt å blomstre enda, men jeg vil tro at det ikke er så veldig lenge nå, før vi begynner å se knopper i dem som har kommet lengst i hvert fall. Så før vi går bort på plantedelen, så kan jeg vise dere her. En rose som har overlevd inn, og som kommer med flotte skudd. Tusenfrydene har jeg kjøpt nå i år. Og så er det en kamelia som står bak der, helt grønn. Ikke noen knopper i år dessverre. Den overvintrer i et kaldt rom i kjelleren. Og har ofte knopper når den kommer opp, men av en eller annen grunn så hadde den ikke det i år. Så står det et fikentre bak der. Det ble tatt opp og satt i stua. Nå hører dere sikkert at det regner på taket forresten, eller snør rettere sagt. Det likte ikke så godt å komme opp på stua, så det begynte å miste bladen. Men det er noen igjen, og så kommer det nye skudd. Her for eksempel. Det er grønt og nytt, så det vil nok komme seg. Så er det noe iris som er helt avblomstret, og så er det en julerose, helleborus, som står bak her. Skal vi se, det var litt vanskelig å se den. Her. Den har jeg kjøpt i år. Jeg har helleborus ute i hagen som har vært her i flere år, men dem er under snøen enda. Og så er det plantebordet da. Bak her er det tagetes fløyelsblomster som jeg har sådd inn og som har begynt å få knopper nå. Så er det mangold. Akkurat den her har stått inn helt til i dag. Men jeg har en til her, som sto inn lengst sammen med den andre, men som nå har stått ut her i flere uker. Og det ser ut som den har vokst nesten like bra den. Jeg har plantet ut noen som sto oppe I de samme krukkene, som har fått større krukker. De fikk jo en sånn, ble satt tilbake når de ble plantet over, men de kommer nå for fullt. De her har jeg forresten høstet av en gang. Vi har hatt risotto med mango. En tomatplante som jeg har tatt sjansen på satt ut. Jeg har mange tomatplanter inn, som skal flyttes ut nå snart. Etter hvert så det sånn her at vi skal ta vekk de her hyllene, og så skal tomatene og andre, eventuelt andre vekster plantes ned under her. Så vil de jo vekse seg stor sånn at den går helt opp til taket. Her det pak choi, som jeg tenker at jeg kan begynne høst av nå, snart. Det jo en sånn japansk salat. Tagetes, som plantet ut her for ikke så veldig lenge siden. En stokkrose som står bak der. Frø som jeg tok fra et kloster utenfor London, som jeg bruker å besøke. Så har jeg sådd spagettigresskar. Jeg har sådd 8 stykker, tror jeg, men det bare 2 som har kommet opp foreløpig I hvert fall. Jeg har sådd erteblomster som ikke har kommet opp enda. Jeg har sådd erter som kommer for fullt, og som nå skal begynne å brukes I salata. Jeg har mer pak choi her. Den pak choien dere så I sted ble sådd inn og har stått inn under vekstlys lenge. Den her sådd ut I drivhuset mens det var vinter, og har stått her hele tiden. Og så har jeg rad med gullerøtter bak I melkekartongene. De sådde jeg bare for noen dager siden, så de har ikke begynt å komme opp enda. Og her ned på noen gamle aviser, så ligger georgineknollene mine. De har også overvintret ned I kjelleren, et kaldt rom. Og har nå fått komme opp hit, skal snart I jorda. Tror det blir noen varme dager nå over helga, så da skal jeg få satt dem inn og potta. Det en spesiell grunn til at jeg har tatt dere med til drivhuset I dag. Og det at jeg skal så veidfrø. Jeg har jo snakket om veid på kanalen min, og det var 3 stykker som sa at de hadde veidfrø som jeg kunne få. Og på tirsdagen så fikk jeg 2 konvolutter I posten. Her var en konvolutt fra Bente. Bente som har YouTube-kanalen Indigo in Green, med en liten hilsen, og veidfrø oppi her. Bente sier at hun har fått veidfrøen av Benedikte Ingstad. Tusen takk, Bente. Og så det en konvolutt her, en helt skikkelig tjukk konvolutt, med veidfrø fra Stjernehagen på Tingvoll. Og de frøene har jeg fått fra Kari, som ser på podcasten min. Kari hadde laget det her kortet, som var med. Et fantastisk nydelig sånn scrap-kort. Og Kari kunne fortelle I brevet som var med at det papiret bak her, et brunt papir som treet vekst på, det det hun som har laget. Jeg skrev litt om det inne I kortet, men hun skrev mer om det I en e-post til meg, så den har ikke jeg her akkurat nå. Det laget av knivtjuke. Så nå skal dere få være med på å så veidfrø. Jeg har sagt til Terje I dag at jeg ønsker meg 2 nye plantekasser bak I hagen, og den ene plantekassa skal være til veidfrøen. Nå det sånn at jeg litt usikker på om de her frøene trenger stratifisering eller ikke. Jeg sår I sånn gamle druebokser. Perfekt å bruke til såing. Stratifisering, det betyr jo at frøene må stå kaldt en stund, I frost helst, eller eventuelt I kjøleskap. Så det jeg har tenkt å gjøre nå, det at jeg skal ta både av frøene fra Bente og frøene fra Kari, så skal jeg ta 3 bokser. Altså 3 bokser med frø fra Bente og 3 bokser med frø fra Kari. Og så skal den ene boksen fra begge to da få lov å stå inn her, og så skal en boks fra begge to settes I et kjøleskap inn, og så skal en boks fra begge to settes ut I hagen, og så skal jeg dekke det med snø. Vi har såpass mye snø enda, og det meldt fortsatt noen netter med frost. Så får vi se om alle spirer, om noen av dem spirer, eller om ingen spirer. Det vet jeg jo ikke. Da har jeg fylt jord i alle seks plastkoppene her. Jeg har tatt jord fra bedet under denne benken som jeg jobber med. Det er fantastisk god jord. Den har jo vært her i flere år, men den... nå får jeg ikke opp den posen. Får klippe den opp da. Eller jeg får ta de andre først. Vi bruker bokashi, sånn at jorda her har fått masse bokashi. Det er jo sånn matavfall, kompost, som står inn, og så blir veldig god jord. Nå tar jeg litt godt med frø oppi. Den posen fra Kari var det masse frø i, så jeg tar sjansen på å putte oppi ganske mye. Resten har jeg tenkt å så direkte ut i den kassen som jeg håper Terje får snekret til meg. Det var da veldig da, å få fingrene til å klare å åpne denne posen. Jeg må nok bare ødelegge den. Det skulle være en stor mulighet for å få en pose snekret nå. Vi har jo god tid nå når det er noen korona-lockdown. Så jeg håper det. Terje har en del andre snekkerprosjekter, vet jeg. Men jeg håper at han får snekret en par kasser til meg. Da var det frøene fra Bente, og dem da må jeg da fordele i tre. Så det blir dem fra Kari som blir plantet i den kassen som jeg skal ha ut. Sånn! Så skal jeg fylle på litt jord over sånn at den dekkes, og så skal jeg skrive på sånne lapper, pinner, wide fra Bente. Og så skriver jeg ofte datoen jeg sår, og jeg er 16.4.20. Den var fra Bente. Så kan jeg skrive på en lapp fra Kari også, mens jeg filmer. Wide fra Kari. Ser dere at jeg skriver? Ja, det vises på filmen. 16.4.20. Så skal jeg skrive på fire pinner til. Så da blir det spennende å se om dette blir wide frø. Og veldig spennende å finne ut om det går an å få planta, nei, fargene og noe garn etter hvert. Men plantene trenger visst 2 år for det. Så her handler det om tålmodighet. Da er 6 potter klar. 2 står ut med snø over seg. De har dere sett på et bilde. 2 skal få stå inn her, skal vanne dem, og 2 skal inn i kjøleskap i kjelleren. Jeg har en hageblogg, akeleiehagen.no, hvor jeg også kommer til å skrive om det her, og en hel masse andre ting fra hagen. Jeg har også en drivhusblogg, som jeg kaller Nederst i hagen. Jeg legger lenker både til akeleiehagen.no og Nederst i hagen under videoen.